It is apparent that South Africa, and indeed the world, would never know how Prophet Shepherd Bushiri and his wife mysteriously disappeared from South Africa in November 2020 into Malawi whilst they were on bail. In his first ever interview exclusively on Times Television, partly in the Malawian language of Chichewa, Prophet Bushiri sarcastically likened his escape to a victim of a burning house.
We have got so many people here from Somalia. Okay? They didn't have to tell their country they were leaving Somalia when there was war. When their life or when their lives were endangered, you don't say, well, I am leaving now. When you feel your life is threatened, number one. So there was no need for me to come and say I'm leaving when I know that the same people who wants to kill me are using state resources to monitor my movements, and they even applied in the course to say we want him to be in one house. He must not move. And they tried to make the whole thing a house arrest. Well, it was not a house arrest. And one would wonder, why were they so much particular to push a narrative that the courts should confine him in one place and my life is on threat and I've come on, reported that, hey, my life is in danger here. I have gone to them, to police, and I've told them with evidences. They want to kill me. I have opened cases. I have all case numbers. When I wanted to be killed, when they came to kill me, I opened cases. Now, if this is the same state protecting the same people, how would you come and stand and say, wow, now I'm leaving? They took your passports. They took you everything. All my rights are taken out. I have exhausted. Now the only last thing is you take matters into your own hands. I'm a citizen of this country. I'm protected by the constitution of this country. And the only thing I had to do is to seek refuge from my country.
News broke out on the 13th of November 2020 that a couple had fled South Africa to their home country while on bail.
We start with our breaking news. Self-proclaimed Prophet Shepherd Bushiri has left the country. He says in a statement that he and his wife temporarily left for Malawi due to safety concerns. He says they will only avail themselves once there's an agreement to give him a fair, just and impartial trial.
Since then, officials responsible for their escape until today are still struggling for answers as to how the Bushiris fled South Africa.
So when we heard that Bushiri has left, we wanted to know what mechanism has she used, because chairperson, the Bushiris were instructed by the court to hand in their passports, their travel document. But then we consulted our movement control system. We requested it to show us the movement of these two people through our ports of entry. And our movement control system indicated that the last time the Bushiris went officially through any port of entry in South Africa was on the 19th of January 2019, when they entered South Africa through the OR Tambo International Airport. I checked with my counterpart in Lesotho, and they checked with Lesotho International Airport. There were no chartered flight that landed on Maseru Airport for last week. The first flight that landed and is still there was bringing a team from Burundi, and it landed on Sunday, a day after all this saga happened. So the issue of Lesotho, we dismissed. So that's why, chairperson, we issued a statement that the Bushiris did not leave with the president of Malawi. Neither did they go through our port of entry.
In the 57 minutes interview, Prophet Bushiri made it clear that going back to South Africa was not an option, even if he was given the chance.
One of the conditions that you said was that if they were to assure you that there's going to be a fair trial, that all these complaints that you've complained, they're going to take care of them, you would go back. Do you still stick to that?
No, no. Because they've already assured. You see, just 2 days ago, they arrested lawyers. So who represent them?
So you've changed that. You're no longer interested.
Trust you me, there'll be no fair trial in South Africa. That I can assure you, what they're doing is completely, completely wrong. You don't do those type of things. If those lawyers that have got cases as they claim, or they've got issues, why not arresting them? This is the first time. This is the third time. And shockingly, all these lawyers are the ones I used to open cases against them. And not only that, they went further to arrest an independent investigator who I hired to investigate them. How do you do that? And I mean, this is a professional type of work. They arrested the independent investigator who has got all investigations of them. Arresting him for what? Now, whatever they may claim, why not charging them? Why not saying, okay, these are the cases we have, but just picking them, you know, after the whole day from 6 in the morning, releasing them. Another day, picking them after 3 months, and they've got messages every day they get. Tomorrow we're arresting you. Tomorrow, why? And they were doing the same things to me.
This is in reference of his earlier statement when he arrived in Malawi, that if conditions were made right, he would return to South Africa to face trial.
I'm not here to run away from trial. As I said, I would want to have this trial be done. But I don't think there will be fairness in this trial if these issues are not considered. One, that my safety in South Africa is not okay. I am seeking my safety to be considered, that the government of South Africa should assure me of my safety, as I have said that my safety is not okay. I also feel, as a second point, that there's a conflict of interest. I open cases against these people who all the times are the ones who are arresting me. And I feel that there's injustice. I can't have a fair trial in such regard, in such cases, where same people, I opened the cases prior to them arresting me, are the same people who are coming after me.
He said his decision was as a result of the unfair treatment and injustices meted out to him and his wife in South Africa.
So we went to the courts, we appeared in the courts, they gave us a bail, we complied. Each time they needed me and my wife in the courts, we were right there, okay? But each time we went for trial, they postponed it. They said, we are postponing because there is the witnesses for their side are not ready, okay? So they did that for 2 years. I was going to court every single time, and they kept on postponing, okay? They kept on postponing. They kept on postponing. Now, you have to know who arrested me. The same people I opened the cases against. Who do you think you are? You think we can lose jobs because of you? When I saw this unfairness happening, I tried to go to the Constitutional Court in South Africa, where I was. I have all my constitutional rights to be heard before this court. They denied me. Not hearing me out. They denied me to go there. I have the evidence of them denying me to go to the constitutional courts. Now, you tell me, every person has got a right to life. My life is on threat. Number two, I know that I'm going to face an unfair trial in South Africa.
He said he was convinced that he would not have a fair trial due to the interference of the judiciary by politicians.
And it's quite shocking how these corrupt police officers are being protected. And trust you me, it just makes me lose respect on the judicial system of South Africa. Because in the first place, why are they protecting these people? 2 days ago, they arrested my lawyers. Where have you seen that on earth? If I go to South Africa right now, if I get extradited to South Africa right now, who will represent me? Because I need lawyers. I have got rights to have lawyers to represent me. And these lawyers are now arrested. Now, they are taken into cells, not once. This is the third time the whole day, and being told in the evening that no, we're not proceeding with arresting you, and being released. Right now, my lawyers have written me a letter to say they're withdrawing, representing me. So if I go to South Africa, who will represent me? And that just shows you how unfairly I'll be treated, the injustice that I'm suffering right now. There is a legal system of South Africa. Then there's a legal system of Malawi. So these systems are not being interfered by politicians. And that's the good thing. You see, they're not being interfered by politicians. You know, unfortunately in South Africa they are. That's why I'm telling you, I can't have a fair trial. You saw ministers in South Africa commenting about court matters. You know, speaking, oh, Bushiri this, Bushiri that, and they were very personal and emotional. None in Malawi commented, because in Malawi they respect the rule of law. And that's why I'm telling you that I've got so much assurance to say in Malawi it will not be a political issue. It will be a legal issue. Because none in Malawi interfere into the whole system. In South Africa, they did. The whole minister in South Africa even lied, you know, in parliament to say Mr. Bushiri and his wife entered South Africa 2010. Well, I married in 2011. Okay? I married in 2011. All their first time they came here, and he lied a lot of things that he lied. Oh, they've got 5 passports. You know, you are aware in Malawi that when you get your passport is full with stamps. The moment your passport is full, you have a right to go and apply another passport. And I travel a lot. When that passport is again full, you come to Malawi, you get another passport, they tell you your passport is full. Now, just to make it complicated and look like I'm a criminal, and he had to make a statement to say, oh, the Bushiris, they've got 5 passports, that's just to make it like, you know, and how they're interfering into this issue is so worrying.